Good morning, lovelies. Today I'm sharing 7 ways that you can find inspiration for your world building. World building is the process of creating a fictional world, often with fantasy or science fiction elements. This is done for role-playing games like Dungeons and Dragons, storytelling, or sometimes just for the hell of it. But it can also be a very daunting task. I mean, you are creating an entire world, and sometimes, no matter how hard you try, you just can't brainstorm new ideas. Tolkien came up with everything already, didn't he? Hopefully, this video will help you out. Alright, these 7 spots are where I personally go to find inspiration for world building my stories. Number 1. Your own story. This one obviously only applies to writers who are trying to write a story here rather than pure world builders. And maybe some game masters. Basically, ask yourself, what does the story need from its setting? Because that's what your fictional world is. It's a setting. This is a good question to keep in mind throughout the world building and storytelling process as a reminder to not go overboard or sweat over the little details. Those might become important later on, but at this point, we're just writing down the basics and handling the very broad strokes. You can hammer out the smaller details during revision, after you've written the first draft and you know exactly what details you need to fill in. Number 2, other authors, specifically AuthorTube and YouTube channels. Hi! They'll bring up questions or ideas that'll get your gears turning. I personally use Hello Future Me and some videos from Overly Sarcastic Productions, especially their Trope Talks playlist. Also, shameless self-promo here, I do have an entire playlist dedicated to helping you build different parts of your world. It'll be linked at the end of this video. Number 3, other fictional worlds. There's nothing wrong with checking out what other authors have done and asking yourself, how would I have done this for this type of story or that kind of society? What would happen if Middle-earth had access to 21st century technology? What if Pokemon-like creatures existed in Pride and Prejudice? What if Hogwarts was located in Atlantis? Obviously, you have to be careful not to just write fan fiction here, but asking questions about other authors' worlds can help you craft your own. Number 4, world history. Studying human history is an excellent way to understand not just how human society and culture works, but human individuals and how the two fuel each other. Why do wars start and end? How do natural disasters affect different types of cities? How does technology impact culture and individual livelihoods? Of course, you can also just take an ancient or medieval civilization and use that as the starting point for your fictional civilization. This is especially useful if you choose one that has roughly the same type of terrain and natural obstacles that your story uses. If your sci-fi culture lives on, say, an Arctic planet, look at how the Inuit and Siberians and Vikings survived similar conditions. Now, on a related note, number 5, modern day cultures. This is usually how we get dystopian stories, because they ask the question of what if this current technology or that political trend gets out of hand? You end up with the Hunger Games. Now, a brief warning here, especially as to my last point, beware of cultural appropriation. Getting inspiration by a civilization of color, that's one thing. That's how we got Avatar: The Last Airbender. Simply taking another culture and sticking it in your story unchanged, that's dicey. And it's also bad writing. The whole point of writing is to put your own spin on things, not to just copy and paste from reality. Also, make sure you're not falling for old bad tropes about civilizations of color. Having your civilized kingdom be white and then all the villainous barbarians be all people of color is going to raise issues and land you in hot water. Number 6, the natural world. Okay, so here's a fun fact. In the Amazon, there's a thing called the Amazon River Dolphin. It is an honest-to-God dolphin that lives in fresh water and lives in the Amazon. And I found this out during a documentary of, like, Planet Earth or some documentary. And the image just of, like, you know, like, the river waters were really high because, like, it recently flooded and, like, the dolphins were right there swimming around the trees. That inspired the setting for my current science fiction novel, Citadel, which I'm currently looking for a literary agent for. But yeah, our world is crazy, and you don't have to look far for inspiration. You need a terrifying monster for your hero to fight? Google deep sea creatures and add however many legs or wings you want. Do you want your army to have some very unique mounts? Take two or more real world creatures and mash them together. Or take one small creature and enlarge it. Or research something like dinosaurs or extinct mammals and play around with that. Want a cute animal sidekick for your sci-fi Arctic setting? Take a small desert animal, like, I don't know, a rattlesnake, and add fur. Just have fun with it. It doesn't matter if your first idea sucks, we're looking for inspiration. Just something to get the juices flowing. And number 7, outer space. There's no reason that the world has to look like Earth. Maybe it's a habitable planet, but some parts of it are just as toxic as Venus. Or it's like Mars, only breathable. Or it's got the atmosphere, water, and land masses that are similar to Earth, but the planet itself is the size of Pluto, so the gravity is wonky as all hell. Take a look at some of the distant planets and solar systems that NASA's recently discovered and see if you can incorporate that into your own world. Even asking something as basic as, what if there were two moons instead of one, can create some really cool consequences. Those are my tips for finding inspiration for your world building. Please share yours in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit like and subscribe. And if you're still trying to figure out how to build your world, I've got this whole playlist right here to help you out. So check that out. I'll see you next time. Bye, lovelies.